Welcome to Capital Market Structure, Function and Instruments. Today we are going to discuss another important instrument of capital market, that is government securities. Government securities are bonds or other debt obligations issued by government with a promise of repayment on maturity date. That is, a government security is a bond or debt obligations from the part of the government, and there will be a promise of repayment on the maturity date. That is, we will get back the amount on the date of maturity without any delay. This type of bonds or debt obligations of the governments are known as the government securities. The government securities are issued by the central government and state government. Or it can be defined as, a government security is a tradable instrument issued by central or state government, and it acknowledges the debt obligation of the government, right? That is, the government securities acknowledges or it contains the promises from the part of the government to repay the amount on the maturity date. Government securities can be of two types. They are short term or long term. Short term security, government securities are usually known as, or it is called as, treasury bills, and the maturity period will be less than 1 year. Long-term government securities, usually called government bonds or dated securities, are the second category, and the maturity period of this long-term or government bond or dated securities will be more than 1 year. In India, the central government issues both treasury bills and bonds or dated securities. That means both the short-term securities as well as long-term securities are issued by the central government, while the state government issues only bonds or dated securities. State government issues dated securities mainly, and these dated securities issued by the governments are known as state development loans or SDL. That means there are two types of government securities, short-term and long-term. Short-terms are known as treasury bills, and long-term government securities are known as government bond or dated securities. Central government issues both. State government issues the government bonds, and it is known as state development loans. Some of the important features of government securities are, they are low-risk investment. They are backed by the government's promises and backed by the government's tax exemption schemes, etc. Government securities are usually issued for raising funds for government's expenditure programs, like the infrastructure development projects, etc. Another important feature is that the return also will be less. It is secure, and therefore the return also will be low. The government securities are also known as risk-free gilt-edged securities. That means it is risk-free, and the return is, even though the return is low, it is risk-free, and therefore it is known as risk-free gilt-edged securities, in the sense that a repayment of the amount at the time of maturity is promised by the government. Therefore, it is known as risk-free gilt-edged securities. Government of India also issues saving instruments like saving bonds, national saving certificates, etc. And it includes another category of securities, namely special securities. These special securities are like, in the name of companies, like oil bonds, Food Corporation of India bonds, fertilizer bond, power bonds, etc. They are usually not fully tradable, and therefore not eligible for statutory SLR securities. These are some of the important features of government securities. That is, we have two types of securities, short-term and long-term. Government issues, central government issues, both short-term and long-term. Central government issue, state government issues only the long-term bonds. It is risk-free, then return will be low, and on the date of maturity, the government promises to repay the amount. The full deeds known as risk-free gilt-edged securities. These are mainly used for finding the funds for the sources of expenditure. In addition to these bonds, government issues various other types of bonds like saving bonds, national saving certificates, etc. And government issues special securities also, like oil bonds, Food Corporation of India bonds, fertilizer bonds, power bonds, etc. Major players are RBI, commercial banks, cooperative banks, regional rural bank, primary dealers, institutional investors, retail investors, and FPI corporates. They are the major players of the government securities. There exists mainly two types of securities, short-term and the long-term. Short-term securities are known as treasury bills, and the long-term securities are known as dated securities. What is this dated securities? Dated securities are long-term securities with maturity period of maximum of 30 years. And the rate of interest may be fixed or floating, and the rate of interest is paid on the face value, payable at a fixed time period. Usually half yearly we will get the return, the rate of return. And the public debt office, which is functioning under the Reserve Bank of India, act as registry or depository of government securities and deals with issue, interest payment, repayment of principal amount, etc. That is the role of public debt office, which is functioning under the RBI, is that they are the registry or the depository of government securities. They mainly deals with the issue, interest payment, and repayment of principal amount at the time of maturities. Then we have another category of government securities, namely special securities. Some of the examples of special securities are Food Corporation of India bills, fertilizer company, the bonds of the oil companies, fertilizer companies, etc. These securities are usually long-term, long-dated securities carrying a coupon with a spread of 20 to 25 basis point over the yield of dated securities of comparable maturity. Then the third one is the gilt-edged securities. This refers to the market for government and semi-government securities, which carry fixed rate of interest. And gilt-edged securities are mainly functioned under the guidelines of the RBI, or RBI plays an important role in the gilt-edged security. Therefore, it is safe, secure, and risk-free. Therefore, it is gilt-edged securities. Government has an RBI has an important role also in this regard. Therefore, we have seen three different types of the securities: dated securities, these are long-term; special securities, these are special bonds; and gilt-edged securities, which usually deals with the, or it is a market for government and semi-government securities, and the RBI plays an important role. Now we'll see the features of gilt-edged securities. The term gilt is of British origin. The British called gilt-edged securities to the bonds and securities issued by the British government through the Bank of England on behalf of His or Her Majesty's Treasury. This paper certificate had a gilt-edged. The term gilt-edged security is used in India for the government securities like central government loans and state government loans, because they carry no risk similar to that of British government security. In US, these types of securities are referred to as US Treasury securities. That is, the term was originated in Britain. In India, uses these terms to denote the bonds of central and state government. Then in US, these types of securities are known as US Treasury securities. These terms are used in different parts of the world. Some of the features or the characteristics of gilt-edged securities are given in the following section. They are gilt-edged security market is one of the oldest market in India, and this market plays a significant part of Indian stock market. That is, it is one of the oldest market. It has a significant role in the capital market or stock market. The supply of government securities in market are provided by central government, state government, semi-government and autonomous institutions. Government securities are also held by Reserve Bank of India for purpose and sale of these securities. So another important feature of gilt-edged security is that the securities issued by government organizations are government guaranteed securities and are completely safe as regards payment of interest and repayment of principal is considered. That is, the securities are issued by the government organizations and it is completely safe, and the interest payment and the principal amount repayment is guaranteed. Gilt-edged securities bear a fixed rate of interest. It is lower than other securities market. It has a fixed maturity period. Interest on government security is payable half yearly. Interest that is received from government securities are exempted from the income tax. That is, we don't want to pay income that arises from the government securities in the form of interest. We don't want to pay tax on income that arises from the interest on government taxes. It is not considered as a separate income. Gilt-edged markets are over-the-counter market. Each sale and purpose has to be negotiated separately. It is limited to the institutional investors. These are some of the important features or the characteristics of gilt-edged securities. That is, it is one of the oldest market. It has a significant place supplied by the central, state, semi-government and autonomous institution. RBI also has an important role. It is safe, fixed rate of interest, but it is lower than other securities. Maturity period is fixed. Interest payable is half yearly. Income tax exemption will be, we can avail. Limited to institutional investors over the counter market. Advantages of government securities. First important advantage is that it is risk-free. It is safe. Second one, commitment of payment of interest and principal amount from the part of the government. That is, it is risk-free and the payment of interest as well as the repayment of principal amount is assured. It is held in book entry. Then another one is that government securities are available in a wide range of maturities. That is, we have different options for the government securities, that it ranges from 90 days to 30 years. In accordance with our capacity, we can purchase the government securities. It can be easily, another important feature is that it can be easily sold in the secondary market to meet the cash requirements. Another one is that government securities can also be used as collateral to borrow funds in the repo market. That is, in the repo market, it can be used as a collateral security. Then another one is that the settlement system for trading in government securities based on delivery versus payment. Delivery, at the time of delivery, we will get the payment. It is very simple, safe and efficient system of settlement. Government security prices are readily available due to a liquid and active secondary market and transparent price dissemination mechanism. That is, in the case of the government securities market, will get back the price readily. It is due to the reason that we have a liquid and active secondary market and a transparent price dissemination mechanism also exists. These are some of the important features of government securities. That is, they are safe. There will be a commitment or promises from the part of the government to repay the principal amount as well as the payment of interest. That is in the form of book entry. We can avail in a wide range of maturity ranging from 90 days to 30 years. It can be sold easily in the second market. These government securities can be used as collateral to borrow from the repo markets. It has a very easy settlement system and it is based on delivery versus payment. It is very simple, safe and efficient. That is, at the time of the giving bank of the securities itself will get the amount. We can sell this government securities in the market because we have a liquid and active secondary market. Price is readily available and we have a transparent price dissemination mechanism also with respect to the government securities. These are some of the important features of the government securities or the advantages of gilt-edged securities.